Hello dear students, welcome to another biology class. In today's class I am going to start a new topic of first QC science. The name of the topic is plant kingdom. Let us start with the general characters of kingdom planted. Already we have discussed in the last class, but one more time we will discuss the characters of kingdom plant. First of all, we start with the general characters. General characters of plant kingdom. The first character of this kingdom is it includes all eukaryotic chlorophyll containing organisms commonly called plants. This kingdom includes all eukaryotic chlorophyll containing organisms called plants. So the organism which are coming under this kingdom are eukaryotic and they are bearing chlorophyll and they are called the plants. Second character is they have diverse habitats. They have diverse habitat. They have habitat. Habitat means the place where they live. On soil, water, and helipads. They live in soil, on soil, in water, or as epiphytes. Epiphytes. So, what is the meaning of epiphytes? Epiphytes are the plants which grow on the another plants, but they not depend for their food. They get only shelter. They prepare their own food. They get only shelter on the another plants. So for example, orchids growing on mango plants are good example for the epiphytes. We are discussing the general characters of plant kingdom. Majority of the plants are autotrophs, but some are insectivorous and parasites also. So autotrophs means the plants which prepare their own food by photosynthetic function, because they have the chlorophyll. And by using the chlorophyll, they prepare their own food by the process called the photosynthesis. But some are insectivorous and parasite also. Insectivorous plants are those which feed on insects. For example, bladderwort and the Venus flytrap. Parasite means one which depends on another plant. For example, cuscuta is a parasitic plant. The next character of kingdom plantae is the plant body may be talus or it may be differentiated. The plant body may be talus or well differentiated into root, shoot and leaves. So some of them have thallus plant body or thalloid plant body. Thallus means the plant body which is not differentiated into root, shoot, leaves. But some are differentiated into root, shoot and leaves. You may see the plant body of plant are either they may be well differentiated or they may be not well differentiated or undifferentiated. The next character is reproduction. Reproduction. They show vegetative reproduction, asexual reproduction and also sexual type of reproduction. Plants show vegetative reproduction, asexual and also sexual. Vegetative reproduction takes place by the fragmentation of the plant body, and this fragment will later develop into a new individual. Asexual reproduction takes place by the help of certain spores, and sexual type of reproduction takes place by the formation of gametes, and when these male and female gametes fuse together, zygote is forming, and this zygote later develops into a new individual. The next character is they exhibit alternation of generation. Alternation of generation means your plant has two phases in its life cycle. One is diploid sporophytic phase and another one is haploid gametophytic phase. These two phases are alternating to each other. Diploid sporophytic phase produces the spores, whereas haploid gametophytic phase produces the gametes. And this gametophyte is always haploid, whereas sporophyte is diploid. The length of these two phases and whether they are free living or dependent, it is different in different plants. So these are the some of the general characters which are applying all the plants or the groups of plants in the which are coming under the plant kingdom. Now we will move to the next segment of this topic, that is classification of plants. Let us discuss about the classification of the plants or kingdom plant. So the kingdom plant is divided into sub-kingdoms. Kingdom Plantae, first of all, divided into sub-kingdoms. Into two sub-kingdoms, one is Cryptogamy, another one is Phanerogamy. There are two sub-kingdoms, one is Cryptogamy, another one is Phanerogamy. The plants which are without seeds are come under the group Cryptogamy. Plants without seeds are coming under the group Cryptogamy. And plants which produce the seeds are come under this group. Plants with the seeds are come under the group Phanerogamy. The Cryptogamy is further divided into three divisions. It's divided into three divisions. One is Thallophyta. Another one is Bryophyta and Pteridophyta. So these are the three divisions of subkingdom Cryptogamy. In the same manner, Phanerogamy is also divided into two divisions. So the one is the two divisions, they are Gymnospermae and Angiospermae. Gymnosperm and Angiosperms. Phanerogams are also called the sporophyta. They also called the spermatophyta. They also called the spermatophyta. Phanerogamy is also called the spermatophyta. So let us see the further divisions of or further classification of these the groups. Telophyta is nothing but algae group, which has algae. And these algae are further divided into three classes. Classes of algae. Three classes. One is green algae. Brown algae. And red algae. So bryophyta has, so further it is divided into three classes. Three classes are there: liverworts, hornworts and mosses. They are liverworts, hornworts and mosses. In the same manner, pteridophyta is also divided into five classes. There are five classes: Psilopsida, Lycopsida, Equisetopsida, and Pteridophyta, and the last one is Meratiopsida. So we commonly call the ferns. So these are the five classes which come under the Pteridophyta group. In the same manner, Gymnosperm is again divided into five classes. Gymnosperm has five classes. They are Psychopsida, Cycadopsida, next one is Gingopsida, and third class is Coniferopsida. And fourth one is Neotopsida. Sorry, there are four classes. Neotopsida. So like this, Gymnosperm again divided into four classes. Angiosperm has only two classes. One is monocotyledons and dicotyledons. So this is the brief outlook of the classification of plant kingdom. Now we'll discuss little bit about further classification in the angiosperm. So angiosperms are classified with the help of three types of classification systems. There are three types of classification system. One is artificial system of classification. Another one is the natural system of classification. And third one is phylogenetic system of classification. Let us see one by one. First of all, we'll discuss about the artificial system of classification. Artificial classification system. So this system or classification system proposed by the Carolus Linnaeus. It's proposed by the Carolus Linnaeus. And this classification is based on only some gross morphological or superficial characters like the habit, color, number, and shape of the leaves. It is based on gross morphological superficial characters like habit, color, number, shape of leaves, or on the number of androtiums. Androtium. So this system of classification is based on the only some of the superficial characters. Androtium structure, number and structure of androtium. So, but this classification has many demerits. So, let us see the demerits of this artificial classification system. Demerits. The first demerit was this classification system separated all the closely related species and included far related species, because this classification was based on only some morphological or vegetative characters. The first demerit is separated closely related species and included far related species, because it's based on some morphological characters or features. This is the one demerit. The second demerit of this classification is, so they have given equal importance or weightage to both vegetative characters and sexual characters. Given equal weightage to both vegetative and sexual characters. The vegetative and sexual characters have given the equal importance or equal weightage. But as we know, these vegetative characters are more often affected by environment. There is lot of chances to, they may change in from one generation to another generation. But sexual characters are not like that. Vegetative characters are superficial and they are morphological characters. They may affect by the environmental factors. They may change suddenly from one generation to another generation. But then also they have given equal importance to these two type of characters. That's why this is the demerit of this classification. Then another type of classification, our next type of classification is natural system of classification. Second type of classification is natural system of classification. Natural classification system. So this natural classification system proposed by the two scientists. One is George Bentham and another one is Joseph Dalton Hooker. And this classification system is based on natural affinities among the organisms. It is based on natural affinities. Based on natural affinities among the organisms. It not only considered external features, it also gave equal importance to internal structure also, internal features also, like the structure, ultrastructure, anatomy, embryology, and also phytochemistry. So it's not only gave importance to internal structure or external structure, they also gave equal importance to internal structure. The next system of classification is phylogenetic classification system. Phylogenetic classification system, which is the most acceptable classification system, because this classification is based on evolutionary relation between the various organisms. It is based on evolutionary relation between the organisms. Evolutionary relation between the organisms. This classification assumes that the organism belonging to the same taxa are having common ancestors. It assumes that organisms belonging to same taxa are having common ancestors. For example, if you say the Panthera leo and Panthera tigris, so this is the lion and this is the scientific name of tiger. So Panthera is a genus of both lion and tiger. And genus is one of the taxa in Linnean hierarchy. And when these two organisms share a common or a same taxa, it shows that they are originated from a common ancestors. So this is the assumption given by the phylogenetic classification system. And this classification is proposed by Engler and Fraenkel. It's proposed by the Engler and Frantz. So these are the three types of classification. So next, as the biological field developed, we have collected information from many different sources, and another three types of classification have developed. They are numerical taxonomy, cytotaxonomy, and chemotaxonomy. So in numerical taxonomy, so the number and codes are assigned to all the characters. The data are then processed. In numerical taxonomy, number and codes are assigned and data are then processed. Data are then processed. In this way, each character has given equal importance in numerical taxonomy. Then cytotaxonomy is the one which is based on cytological feature. It is based on cytological features like chromosome number, structure, and behavior. So this is called the cytotaxonomy. Chemotaxonomy, that uses the chemical constituents of the plant to resolve the confusions. So these are the new way of classification types. So here I am going to end up this class. We'll continue with algae in the next class.